Okay. Anyway, I'll just go for, because I do see that people are here. I just, for some reason, cannot see comments. So if you are commenting, please leave comments. I'll read the comments after, and then I will reply. But anyway, I'm going to start off by showing you guys the fabric I'm going to be using for this guy. And I have it right here from Puppet Pelts. This is the nylon. No, I'm sorry, not the nylon. Nylon is gone. This is the polyester fleece. So, Lori at Puppet Pelts did a custom blend, a custom dye for a baby Yoda, or a Yoda. I don't know what they're gonna call it, Yoda or baby Yoda, or maybe they can't actually use that name because of trademark stuff. But they did come up with a custom color, especially for people who want to make everyone's favorite baby alien. That's popular now. I told her I was doing it, and then here we are. Let me get this open. Actually, let me switch the camera for you guys. Ooh, look at that. Oh, come on, of course. Hold on, I'm sorry about the camera. Let me fix that really quick. Sorry, guys. Yoda Gray, you can see. That's what it's called. Let me fix the white balance here. Have it on my hand. That's pretty accurate. Okay. So you guys can see it a little better. Yes, there it is. Puppet Pelts Yoda Gray. Okay. And actually, in the camera, it does look kind of grayish. This is the backing, but it's definitely a greenish gray, and it's actually, it is perfect. There's two blends here. Okay, there's Yoda Gray and Yoda Green, and again, I will say they are both a shade of green. I'll show you a nice good look here. Oh, yeah. Look at that. This is going to be perfect. So looking at them together, wow, this is so nice. This is really, really nice. I'm not sure which one. I think I'm gonna go with the lighter one, because if I did a real Yoda, I think I'd use this. And if, since I'm doing baby Yoda, I think I'm gonna go with the lighter one. So I may have to make a second one out of this, or actually I might be able to use this as contrasting fabric. Actually, that's probably what I'll do for different parts, like the eyelids or something like that. But anyway, I am going to put this back in the bag for now. Let me just open it up so you guys can see it. The polyester fleece. Looking good. Again, it's a little bit brighter of a green than it is on the camera. My coloring isn't perfect on there. So I just wanted to show you this, what we're going to be using to cover it before we get started. It's going to be a while till we get to the fabric anyway, though. I just wanted to show you that out of excitement, because first thing I wanted to do was to make the eyes, and I knew I wanted to put a mechanism in them, so here is what I did. First thing I did is I bought what I use a lot of times for the eyes, for characters like this. Well, actually, let me say this before I go on. I wanted this, let me turn it so you can actually see me. Okay. When I was designing this project in my head, I decided that I wanted to make this in a way that people could make this project using things that you could get locally from a craft store or a hardware store. Because normally, because this is going to have an eye blink mechanism, or we're gonna attempt to, one that I've never even made before, not at least with these materials. Because a lot of times when I do this style of eye blink mechanism, I use these custom pieces I get from a what would you call it? A modeling shop store, and like each just single round eyeball is like close to $10 each. So just for the plastic alone to make the eyes, it's close to like $50 or more, which is it's reasonable if you're doing this professionally and selling these kind of puppets for a lot of money. But two things. First of all, I will not be selling this character since it's a copyrighted character. This is part of a collaboration with a couple of artists. This is a collaboration with Puppet Pelts, collaboration with Daniel Becker of Disney Dan, and with Uncle Jesse from Uncle Jesse's YouTube channel, who supplied me with some 3D renderings of Baby Yoda to kind of use for scale. But anyway, I wanted to use materials that you could source locally or very cheaply from places like Amazon. So my plan was to use these kind of wooden balls here. And I like using these a lot. Let me switch back so you guys can see. I use these for puppets all the time. All the time. And they look like this. They're often called, I've actually mostly seen them called doll heads. But this brand that I happen to get this time is called ball knobs. And it's a sphere, except for it's flat on one end and has the hole, which is perfect for puppets because then it's pretty much ready to go. I make a bracket for the bottom and just screw it into the eyes, and then you're all set for eyes. But one thing I noticed was with this is, at least for a mechanism, you need these to be super consistent. And these are perfectly consistent for just making eyes for puppets. Again, I use them all the time for eyes for puppets. But when you go on to mechanisms, it really has to be a pretty perfect sphere, okay? And this is a little bit long. It's a little bit long this way, so it wouldn't quite work with the mechanism. And I learned that after I started painting them, but I'll get to that later, maybe. But anyway, so then what I bought instead, which was kind of a pain, was these wooden balls. And I'll have links to these in the YouTube video when the YouTube video comes out, which hopefully will not be too long. So then I bought, oh, let's get that shake to stop. So then I bought these eyes, okay, or rather these wooden balls. These are like perfect. I measured them with a micrometer, and they are at way definitely accurate enough. But the problem is they don't have a flat end. I did want a flat end for putting it into the bracket. So what I did was I just cut one side down, and then I perfectly put a hole right through the middle of them. And I have different sets of these. I already made them and painted them so I could show you guys. So I drilled a hole straight through, right in the middle, and then I painted them. Okay? At first, I painted them black. I have tons of sets of these because I tried all different things. At first, I painted them black because I wanted that, that Baby Yoda look. I thought those eyes would look really, really nice. Okay? But then, actually, another teacher at my school gave me this spray that you spray on things that are black, and it makes it look kind of like galaxy-ish. And these look stunning. Look at this. Hold on, let me get these off. Look at that. Well, there's just some plastic shavings on there. Look at these. So I think I'm gonna use these for my Baby Yoda eyes. And just to be clear, these eyes here are made out of the wooden spheres. Okay, but anyway, what I still needed was eyelids. So the perfect thing I found that isn't that expensive modeling plastic that I was telling you about is actually something I recommended in one of my other eye videos, the jumbo ping pong balls. Okay, and for eyelids, I often use the orange ones. But I think for the sake of this video, it'll be easier to see with the white ones. But I found that these actually coincidentally fit perfectly over this and still have a little bit of air, a little bit of space between it to slide back and forth. So, there we have it. The jumbo ping pong balls. So, what I'm going to do now... So, I already have these two ping pong balls ready to go with the holes drilled through them. They just are not cut away like this test one was. So, without any further ado, I'm going to start putting that together now, hopefully. Actually, you know what? I should build the rest of the head first. The rest of the form for the head. I'm probably getting a little bit ahead of myself. But I do want to show you how it works, though. So let me just... It's a real snug fit with this thing, so I gotta drill it in. Oh, actually, is this even right? Okay, let me see here. I'll show you guys. So you can get the full effect. So anyway, so... And I'll put some little washers in there, but look at this. This wooden ball is not moving. You can see the flat edge right there. But this is the perfect size. And again, I'll put little washers in there when it comes time. That's not the actual lid I'm going to use, but it's going to be my template for the lid. Actually, I'll probably use this side. Yeah, that's perfect. Oh, it's so Yoda-ish. Okay. But anyway, in order to attach these eyes to something, I need a base for the head. So, what I decided to do, I was like, what if I build this around a piece of PVC pipe as the kind of the cranium? And that's what I'm going to do. But this PVC is regular PVC. And I just figured it'd be a little bit heavy once I have the whole puppet built. So instead, I got this schedule. This is called Schedule 40. It's a little bit thicker. And this it used to be white, too. I don't know why it's green now. But it's still PVC. It's the same stuff. But it's half the thickness. This is Schedule 20 PVC. And I use this for a ton of stuff in my puppets. So I did this instead, and I cut off a piece right here. This is 2.5 inches tall, if anyone wants to follow along at some point, probably after when this is all done, to make sure it actually worked out to be a success. And then I just need a base plate in there to mount everything to. And to do that, I just have a 1/4 inch piece of wood that I put right here. Trace around the inside, and then you cut that out. Okay? And again, I did cut that out already, but just so you know, that's all the prep I've done. So from this point forward, I'm going to be figuring it out. So I have this, and this is going to be my mount for my eyes here. So Let me actually start. Okay. I'm just going to bring up a Yoda reference now for while I'm working. Baby Yoda. Okay. I want to make sure I get these kind of it's like Invader Zim, doesn't it? You guys know that show? Oh jeez. So this is a half inch wide. I should put a little half inch mark around this. Cause it's gonna sit on that at least. Actually, this might need to be a little bit taller. Darn. I probably gotta go. Oh, I don't wanna go 3 inches. Maybe I have to. Because if this is. What's not 2 inches anymore? How tall is this now? This is a little less. You know what? I might just make it. If I go 2 inches, there's not a lot to hold on to there, though. Shoot, I gotta cut another one of these quick. Take 2 seconds, but I don't quite want to go 3 inches, do I? I'll go there. I'll go 2¾. Okay, I'll be back in like 30 seconds. Hold on. Okay, here we go. I am back. So, this one is scrapped. Now let me just get my half inch mark here. Okay. Actually, let me get a center line here. Okay. So. If I was to draw a baby Yoda nose, probably be about there, maybe about that big. It might be a little small considering this is just the skull. But that would mean that I'd probably want to start My opening. There? I guess I'll just go for it. What is that? A 1-inch space between them? 1 and 1. Okay, now let me so this is definitely 2 inches wide, so I want to go a little bit wider than the 2 inches. I'll go 2 1/4. Go from there. So 1, 2, there's a quarter. Actually, I'll go to here. No, let's go to, oh, shoot. Now I'm going to go to 2 inches. Because this is at a curve, I probably don't need to overcompensate for it. So let me see here. Okay, so now how tall did I want to go, I said? It's 1 3/4 tall, which means I only shaved off 1/4 inch. So I'll do 2 inches, yeah, I'll do the full 2 inches, and that's this, right? Yeah. That'll definitely have clearance then for the mechanism. And if it's a little bit too big, that's okay, because I can compensate for that with the foam when I start covering this with foam. So it's okay to have it just a little bit bigger, but you never want to go too much bigger than you have to. Oh, I gotta take some pictures of this too. Okay. Now to start cutting that out. And then hopefully it will fit like a glove. Let's get my eye protection. those joints a little more. Definitely gotta go a little bit bigger. Oh boy, and looking at this, I wanna go in, not out. Good to know. Good, good. I just gotta clean this up a bit. It's the second pass. I gotta smooth it out a bit more, but let's see how we're getting there. Okay, we're still a little bit close on the sides there, but we're getting good. Oops. I'm gonna come in just a hair more. Whoops. So there's a bit of space there, but remember that it has to also accommodate the eye blink mechanism as well. So, glad I put a little space there. Looks like I have to shave down just a little bit this edge here. Just a hair more down on that one. There we go. Now these will sit perfectly like that. Okay. And actually, let me put some screws in this. This is way overkill, but this will just keep it easy to take in and out. drill it out though first. Nice and flat too, so Alright, well, I think that's all I'm going to do for today, guys. I don't have a lot of time, but my wife just got home, so I will see you guys next time.